I'll show you how to coach. Here comes Chris Paul. The lob.
36. What are you doing? John.
I figured it out. They can't know where I'm at. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh my God, it's a path to abundance.
Okay, I don't know, path to abundance.
What's going with your head?
But then I didn't go to the gym because
Something bad about to happen?
This is big, dude. I figured it out. What if I told you there was a way to activate your true potentialities?
Potentialities?
That everything you've ever wanted in this world could be yours if you discover the key.
Is this another one of your cons?
No.
Multi-level marketing swindle?
No.
Pyramid scheme?
No, well, maybe. Let me think about it. The year is 2013 AD. I'm in the library reading a book about 1450 BCE when I discover that the Israelites were enslaved for one reason.
Which was?
Don't worry about it, it's not important. But what is important is that the ancient pharaoh, Imhotep.
You mean Imhotep?
No, I don't mean! Imhotep received secret knowledge from the gods. He went from a common slave to a pharaoh, dude. His empire swelled with power. A thick vein of abundance ran through his lands. He became one of the most powerful men of his time. Plus, he became super rich and shit.
Okay, so what was that thing?
Hang on, look at this.
God, what is this?
It's a flipping cartouche, bro! Written in Aramaic. When two eyes kiss and obelisks unite, only then can you unlock your true power and might.
Where did you learn Aramaic?
Rosetta Stone. Oligarchs. French Expressionists. The East India Tea Company. Oliver Platt. Close-up illusionists. They all had the key because they followed the signs. The Masonic Compass. The Jesus Fish. The Eye of Providence. That thing on my medication bottles. Tom Hanks' hairline and the Da Vinci Code all come together to form the key.
Wait a minute, are those?
Are you following where I'm going yet?
Not even remotely.
Okay, the year is 1775.
Stop telling me years.
Ben Franklin is out in his fields fiddling with his dick, herding sheep, he can't get any bread. All of a sudden, he comes across a guy. You know who that guy was?
Thomas Edison. What? Come on, dude. He was born like 50 years after Franklin died.
Exactly. Edison invented a time machine, flew back to Pilgrim times, and helped Jefferson get his act together.
Jefferson? I thought you said Franklin.
Whatever. Leonardo da Vinci is living in the basement of his parents' Duomo.
I don't have time for this right now. Just tell me what it is.
Okay. We're getting there. When I take the words universe and heliotrope, I rearrange the letters.
How are you even doing this?
Yep.
Hey, dude, hurry up. Sab and Lily are gonna be home soon.
Computer, illuminate.
Hello, Jonathan.
It's just John.
Apologies.
Don't let it happen again. Show this foolio what I'm talking about.
Compliance.
There it is. Computer, enhance.
Enhancing.
Computer, dehance.
John, just spit it out right now. What is the key?
What is the thing as a dude that you want to do the least?
I don't know. Eat my own shit.
What? Yeah, that would suck. Okay, what is the thing as a dude you want to do least to another dude?
Eat his shit.
What is always with the shit?
I don't know.
Okay, in our universe, there's a positive and a negative, right? And in our friendship, you're clearly the negative.
Okay, look, I understand that there's something we have to do and then something happens. I get it. What is the thing that we have to do? Tell me.
We can have whatever we want if we touch the tips of our dicks together.
What?
We can have whatever we want if we touch the tips of our dicks together.
Okay, what? That's what this was about? That's the thing? Why would I do that? Why?
Because, dude, it creates a current, a conduit to the vast infiniteness of abundance size. Or what have you.
John, you realize this is really gay.
It's not gay, dude. They would never do that. Who likes that? It doesn't do anything. It probably hurts.
Okay, stop it, all right? Because I'm not doing it. Just forget about it. It's not happening.
Are you seriously gonna pretend like your life isn't shit with your loving, supportive wife and your precious baby? But what if I'm right? What if all of our troubles just vanish with a simple little smush of our dicks? Come on, man. I need this. I don't have anyone. I don't have anything.
Hey.
Dude, it's okay. It's okay.
And honestly, dude, what's the worst that could happen? No one's ever gonna find out. So just open your mind, open your pants. Let's get on with the rest of our lives.
Okay, all right, fine, fine. We'll do it, you happy?
Dude, think about all the potentialities.
It's not even a word.
Yeah, but it could be.
Whoa, whoa, what are you doing?
What, this is how I pee.
Really?
Uh-huh. Ready? I hope that guy at the gym was right.
What?
In my private jet, and he's upset because there's no Ciroc in the mini fridge. Oh yeah, and he wants us to call him Puffy again. Did you know he touched tips with Patrick Ewing? Yeah. Well, gotta go. Let's hang when I get back. I would love to hear about all the amazing ways your life has changed. Namaste. Yeah, I don't have Ciroc because no one likes Ciroc.
Ciroc is a premium vodka.
No, it's not, dude.
Touch. I remember touch. Pictures came with touch, a painter in my mind. Where do I belong?